everybody. How are you? Welcome to our art lessons. I am Miss Karen, and I'm an art teacher, and I love cartooning, and I love to draw animals. So we're going to draw some really fun animals today, but I have an assistant today. Usually I have Jack the Plumber, but Jack the Plumber is doing this huge plumbing job in Iowa. So guess who I brought? Miss Sheena, say hi.
Hello, everybody.
Miss Sheena teaches English, and guess what? She's also my daughter, who I love very much. And I really like your shirt.
I like your shirt, Mom.
I think your shirt's better. So Sheena will be our assistant today, and I hope you have lots of fun doing our drawing lessons. So what you're going to need to start off is a piece of paper. Any type of paper will do. Even if you have lines on your paper, it's okay. This is just a simple piece of printer paper. So a piece of paper, a pencil. My pencil's not sharpened. An eraser, of course. And a pencil sharpener. And that's it. And then if you want to use crayons or markers, colored pencils. Right, Sheena?
Right. Yes, okay. Use whatever you want.
So today we are going to draw some animals from Central and South America. What should be our first animal, Sheen?
Central and South America. Maybe a sloth.
Okay. Do you know any fun facts about sloths?
You know what? I do.
Okay.
I have lots of fun facts about sloths. Would you like to hear them?
I would love to hear them.
Okay. Sloths are very slow-moving mammals.
Slow.
Who live in Central and South America. They spend most of their time hanging out in trees.
Oh, that would be fun.
Usually upside down.
Oh, wow.
Even though sloths are thought to be extremely lazy, they only sleep about 10 hours a day, of course, in a tree.
In a tree. Okay, I would like to sleep 10 hours a day.
Sloths mainly eat the leaves of trees, but sometimes they also like to eat popcorn.
Popcorn? No. Sheena's kidding.
They don't like to eat popcorn. They like leaves.
Leaves.
There are two different types of sloths, two-toed and three-toed sloths.
We're going to draw a three-toed sloth today.
Oh, great. Three-toed sloths are active in the daytime, while two-toed sloths are smaller and even slower than the two-toed sloth. Their claws can be up to 4 inches long.
Whoa.
So that they can hold onto tree branches.
Okay, that makes sense.
And sometimes they like to paint their claws.
No, they don't like to paint their claws.
No, they don't. Sloths don't have good eyesight, but believe it or not, they are good swimmers.
Oh, swimmers.
Because of their long front arms.
Oh, wow.
And they can hold their breath underwater for about 40 minutes.
40 minutes, that's a long time.
Sloths move very slowly. At a pace of about 6 to 8 feet per minute. And three-toed sloths are the slowest animal on Earth.
Oh, wow.
Do you know what they're slower than?
What?
Turtles and snails.
Not a snail.
Yes, they're slower than snails.
Oh, wow. Slower than snails.
Yes.
And turtles.
Yes, they are.
Oh, wow. Jack usually tells us jokes. Do you have any jokes for us?
I do have a joke.
Okay, I want to hear it.
It's a sloth joke.
A sloth joke.
Yes. What are sloths' favorite things to read?
Their favorite things to read? I don't know.
Snoozepapers.
Oh, a snoozepaper.
A snoozepaper.
Because they sleep a lot, and we think they're lazy. I gotcha.
Big snoozers.
Any more?
Oh, I have one more.
Okay, tell me.
Well, what do sloths like to throw in the winter time?
In the winter?
Yes.
I don't know.
Slow balls.
Slow balls. Good one, Sheena. Slow balls instead of snowballs. Okay, are we ready to begin? I hope you have your pencil, your paper, and your eraser. Of course, we're going to need our eraser, right? Okay, so right here, I, as usual, put begin right here. And then I put then right here. So we're going to start with just a circle. Sheena, I really like your shirt.
I like your shirt.
Okay. So let's start with a circle, just like that. Doesn't have to be a perfect circle. That's how we're going to begin. Okay. And then I'll put a little X right there. And we are going to go like this. And we're going to do one. Doesn't that sort of look like a U?
It does.
Right here. Maybe like an upside down umbrella. Okay. And that's it. That's how we're going to begin our sloth. All right. So now, what's he going to be hanging in with his big claws?
A hammock.
No, Sheena. A tree. So for our next step, you can make a whole tree if you'd like. It's your creation. You could do whatever you want. But I'm just going to do a tree branch, okay? So, and I'm going to wiggle my pencil or my marker like that. See how I'm just making a wiggly line? Because trees aren't really straight. And then I'm going to go like that. And I'm going to make another branch up here and maybe one more branch here. Okay, so I got a tree branch that he's hanging on. Wait, how many? He only has two legs hanging, Sheen.
I thought sloths had four.
Yeah,
legs.
Four, right? Oh, and we also need his stomach. So we're just going to go right here like this. Make a little stomach. Okay, now we need the other leg. This back leg here, you're not really going to see, so we're just going to make a line like that. And then look at this. This is his other arm that's going to hang down here. So what we're going to do, we're going to get smaller. See, it sort of could be like a triangle without the point. And then up here, this is where you're going to need your eraser. I'm going to make an oval like that. And that's his hand hanging down. Okay. So let's do his face. Want to do his face? Let's do his face. You can make any type of face you want, and sloths are so cute. I'm going to put another circle here. And look how I wiggled my marker. And I'm going to do an eye and another eye and an oval nose and what a big smile, right? Because my sloth is very happy. Okay, so we got that going. Now, what about, didn't you say they paint their fingernails?
Yeah, they like to paint their claws.
No, they don't, Sheena. Okay, claws, you can make them. Oh, I do want to show you this. I left this one here. We're on this step. You can make them, you can have them be white. You can have them be black. You can have them be pink or purple, whatever color you want. This is your creation. Green, right?
Right.
Our paper keeps falling through. That's funny, huh? Okay. So let's make the claws. Now remember, What did you say? Two-toed and three-toed?
Yes, there are two-toed and three-toed sloths.
Okay.
Which sloth are we making?
We are making a three-toed. All I did was make a line right there. And then here's one more three. Make sure I have three, Sheen.
One, two, three.
One, two, three. Okay. You could get as detailed as you want with that. All right. So we got our claws. We got one, two, three, four legs. And now it's time for the funnest part, the details. And didn't you say they like to eat leaves?
They do like to eat leaves.
Okay, so let's just do some leaves here. I'll make leaves, any type of leaves you want on your tree branches. And you know what? We really don't even need that on there.
Okay.
If you want to take that off. I'll make some leaves. Have fun with the leaves. And don't forget to erase a little bit there. Okay. Let's make this one a little bigger. You could put some lines in your leaves if you want. Leaves are fun to make.
Those are fun leaves.
Yeah. Do they look delicious because that's what our sloth wants to eat? Okay, so now our sloth, I'm going to erase this little X from where we started, which was right here. Erase that. Let's give him or her an eyeball inside this circle. Okay, what do you think?
I think it looks great. So cute.
And then you could do this too. It goes like this. Here, don't put it too close to the, and I'm gonna color it in. Not too close to the smile. Okay, and I'm gonna shorten my smile. That's what your eraser's for, right?
Wow, now it really looks like a sloth.
And then if you wanna give your sloth some fur texture, just go like this, like lines. Isn't that fun to do? Just like that. Okay, and don't forget the back leg here. And a little bit of lines there, a little bit here. Oh, and you can also do some lines here. Okay, I'm gonna color our sloth's nose in. And he's very, very happy. Now, if you want to, also on the trees have lines. Just make some squiggly lines like that. Okay, and then there's your sloth. It's time to color. I am gonna find my basket right here. I love to color with highlighters. So what I usually use are highlighters. You can get them anywhere. They're very inexpensive. And I love to color with the highlights. This is a wipe off marker. But so much fun to do. So I'm gonna add a little green here. I'm not gonna take up too much time coloring. And a little green just to give it, instead of being so black and white here. Okay. And you can make your sloth any color you want. Sheena, if you were drawing a sloth, what color would you make your sloth?
I would make my sloth rainbow colored.
Rainbow colored. That would be so much fun. So if you want, whatever color you want to give your sloth would be fine. I am going to use purple. I like purple. Purple's one of my favorite colors. And you could even mix your colors a little bit. Okay. And where's the other? His other leg. Oh, is he a boy or a girl? If he's a girl, I would give him some eyelashes. Right? If I decided that.
I think girl sloths would have eyelashes.
Yeah, they would. And you can even, I'm going to mix a little green here. Oh, my green's not working too good. Sheena has lots of wipe-off markers. Yes, she does. She likes to use wipe-off markers. I hope I didn't use the highlighter for up here. No, I didn't. Okay. So we are done with our sloth. Let's review very quickly. Okay, you can take that board down, Sheen.
Yay.
So just to review very quickly, we started with a circle right here where I have begin. Circle doesn't have to be a perfect circle. Then we sort of went up here and made like a U, okay? Then we added in a tree branch, or you can add in a whole tree, and we put another circle inside this circle, two eye circles, an oval for a nose, and of course, a smile, right, Sheen?
Yes.
And then we decided, is it a three-toed or a two-toed sloth? And then we just added our details, and here's how my final sloth turned out. And I made, it's a boy. His name's Sam. Sam the sloth.
Sam the sloth.
And he's green and brown and yellow. Okay? So, I hope everybody had fun with that. And remember, very simple. Just start out with a circle. Okay, well, let's think of another animal. What else could we do?
Maybe an anteater.
An anteater.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
An anteater would be fun.
Okay, let's do the anteater.
Do you want to hear some anteater facts?
I do.
Okay. There are small anteaters and giant anteaters. Silky anteaters are about as small as a squirrel.
Oh, wow.
And giant anteaters can be about 7 feet in length.
Oh, my goodness. That's very big.
It is very big. Anteaters like to eat.
Not ants.
Ants,
of course. Of course.
You're right, Mom. Not pizza.
Not pizza.
But really, they prefer termites.
Termites, ooh.
They do not have teeth, but they do have a really long tongue, which can be about 2 feet long.
Oh, wow.
With super sticky saliva.
Ooh.
It helps them to catch the termites and
of
ants.
Of course. Of course.
They can eat up to 35,000 ants.
Oh, wow.
And termites.
A day?
A day.
35,000? Oh, I wouldn't want to eat that many ants or termites.
And sometimes they eat fruit.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Anteaters have long claws, about 4 inches long.
Oh, wow.
They use their claws to dig in the anthills.
Uh-huh.
However, they don't eat all the ants.
Okay, why not?
Because they want to come back to the same anthill for some more yummy ant snacks.
Oh, wow. Yummy ant snacks.
Yes.
Sounds yummy to me. Not at all.
You don't like to eat ants?
No.
They also use their huge knife-like claws if they get in a fight with another animal.
Oh, yeah?
Anteaters are very light sleepers.
Uh-huh.
They sleep about 15 hours a day.
Oh, I would like to sleep 15 hours a day.
Yes, I would
like
too.
I like to sleep. Sleep's very good for you, by the way.
And they are mostly silent.
Okay.
Unless threatened.
Threatened?
Yes.
What do you mean by like a predator or another anteater?
Yes, maybe when they're afraid.
And then do they make a sound?
Yes, they make a sound that's a big cry, and it sounds a little bit like this. Hark.
Wow. And you sound just like an anteater.
Anteaters live in Central and South America.
Oh, wow.
And they like to live in areas with lots of trees.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
And streams.
And streams. Oh, wow.
Do you know why?
Why?
Because there are lots of ants there.
Oh, wow. Lots of ants.
Yes.
Okay. Do you have any jokes? For us?
Of course, I have jokes.
Okay. All right. Well, that's when I start drawing, maybe you could tell us a joke. And I have a story about an ant, and that's why I like the anteaters. So we're going to begin right here. And I have start, and I got an arrow going that way and that way, just like a big upside down U or like an umbrella. Okay. pretty easy, right, Sheen? And then we're going to wiggle our pencil. That's the anteater's tail. And then you said that big, long noses, right? So that's his or her big, long nose. Then we're going to add some details right here. Just legs. That's really it. We're going to add legs and a stomach, right? And then we're going to add some more claws. And then it's going to turn out. You can make it whatever color you want. And look, I love ants. The anteater loves ants. I don't like ants. Do you want to know why?
Why don't you like ants?
Because I got bit by a fire ant on my arm one time. And it was this big. And it was in Florida where you used to live, where you went to school. And I got bit by a fire ant. And my arm was real hot, but it was okay. I didn't even have to go to the doctors or anything. It went away the next day. But it was a little uncomfortable.
Too bad we didn't have an anteater.
I know. Why didn't you have a pet anteater, Sheena?
Well,
that would have been nice.
He probably would have thought that fire ant was too spicy.
Spicy fire ant. Good one, Sheena. Okay. I'd love to hear a joke.
Why don't anteaters ever get sick?
I'm not sure why.
Well, because they have lots of antibodies in their bellies.
Oh, because they eat the ants. Yes. So they got a lot of antibodies. Good one, Sheena. That was really good. I'm going to start right here. And I am going to wiggle, and I'm just going to start like that. Okay. I like that joke. Any more?
I have another joke.
Okay, I want to hear it.
It's about anteaters again.
Okay.
What do you call an anteater who likes to be alone?
I'm not sure. I don't know.
An independent. Pendant eater.
Oh my goodness, Sheen. Your jokes are just too funny for me. Very funny. Thank you for those. Okay, so look, this is the anteater's tail. This is the anteater's long nose. We just are starting sort of kind of with like an upside down U or an umbrella shape. And then we're just going to go like that. And make sure you wiggle your pencil. And there's the tail. I'm going to put a point right here instead of that. I'll do it like that. Did you ever see an anteater?
I have never seen an anteater in real life.
I saw one at the Pittsburgh Zoo. Pretty cool. I was there for their ice cream party. Okay, so then just make a little line there. That's going to be the anteater's nose. Wiggle. And I made this part here bigger because that's where his or her eyeballs are going to be. Okay, so that's it. That's step one. So now we need some legs, right?
Yes.
And the legs are fun to do, and I'm just going to go like that. Okay, that's one leg. How many legs do you think?
I think we need
and
four
I'm gonna
legs.
Do make a little Y right there. See, doesn't that look like a Y?
It
does
right look
there.
Like a Y.
Okay, and then I'm gonna make the front leg like that, and that's it. Okay, starting to look like an anteater. And didn't you say they have lots of ant eye bodies in their stomachs?
Yes, they do.
Okay, then we need a couple more legs, right? The back legs. And I put it behind, and we'll put a little front leg here. We'll worry about the claws later. That's so simple. Okay, how about an eyeball?
I think anteaters have eyeballs.
Yeah. So let's put it up here. I'm going to make this circle pretty big. And they're different colors. I thought they were pretty cool looking. And I'm going to take a line and I'm going to start some details already just to give it a little texture. And we don't know, is your anteater a boy or a girl? My sloth was a boy. I think I'm going to make this a girl. Okay, I love to give eyelashes. Okay, so here's the nose right there. And how about a mouth? Look at that.
Oh, it's a happy anteater.
Yeah. How about some ears? Let's do ears. Here's one. And we'll do one here like that. Okay. And how about an eyeball? And you said they have claws because they make that sound, right?
Yes.
When they are threatened by the predators or for digging in those anthills, right?
Do you mean the har sound?
Yeah, I do. And then our anteater is just not standing in thin air, right? She is on some grass, and maybe there's an ant down here. Use your imagination. Maybe it's a little ant hill right here. Did you ever see an ant hill? Yeah, in the grass. They're small.
Oh,
they're way
yes.
smaller than this, but.
Yes, I have seen an ant hill. There's a little hole in the middle.
Right. And then we need little texture, if you want. Or you could leave your ant like that, but or your anteater like that. I'm going to give a little texture going. I like texture. And I'm just going like this, just making some drawing marks. Okay, I'm not going to do it on her face. I'll do it right there. And then you can color your anteater any color you want. So let's see this over here. Let's hold it right there. Now this one here, I put a little pink, a little orange, a little yellow. I have the ant hill or termite hill. I don't know if termites live in hills. Do you know how much? I think they live in wood. But anyhow, and I put help because they don't want to get eaten. And she has a pink eyelid, and she has some eyelashes, and look what color her claws.
Oh, she has pink claws.
Right. And then right here it says, I love ants. So anyhow, very simple. Remember, we started out with an umbrella shape, and then we wiggled our pencil up here for her tail, and then we made, remember, make a long nose right here. And then we just added the legs and a stomach for the antibodies.
Yes.
And we did that right there and added our legs. And then we just added details right here to turn it out to look like this. How simple is that?
That was pretty easy.
Pretty easy. All right, well, that is all we have for you today. Sheena, you wanna take that?
Yes.
We had our sloth and our anteater, and I hope you had a really, really good time today. I'm so happy that my Sheena, my daughter, was here with me today, and I hope you're spending lots of family time at home. Maybe your whole family could draw a sloth and an anteater. And I really like your shirt, Sheena.
I like your shirt better.
Aww.
I cannot wait to go home and try to draw a sloth and an anteater now.
Right. And are you going to use crayons or pencils? Anything you have laying around the house to make it very simple. And have fun with it. It doesn't have to be a brown anteater or a brown sloth. It could be what? Rainbow colored or unicorn colored, right? And just make up a whole story about it and have fun. And as always, if you want to send in your drawings, you can send them to the Bethel Park Recreation and Community Center Facebook page, and we'll check them out, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for watching. We hope you have fun with our drawings, and we hope you have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.